Sir, excuse me.
Hello, miss. You're not actually from here. I can hear it. What on earth is a young American doing in our beautiful land? Business? Or perhaps tourism?
Oh, it's a long story, believe me.
I see. In any event, you must try and visit our town. You know, Valsimbor is very charming this season. And may I suggest you drop by my tavern? It's the best restaurant in town.
Well, I'd love to, but unfortunately I learned that now I need a pass to get into Valsimbor. I'm looking for someone who can help me get one.
Ah, yes, that's true. That's a pain it is. But you're actually in luck. I may be able to do something for you. This is my wife's pass. She's not well, so she couldn't come with me. The document is perfectly valid, except she forgot to get it stamped at the town hall.
And that's a problem?
I'm afraid so. Without the stamp, the document is worthless. Not that long ago, you just needed to get it officially stamped at the police checkpoint, over there at the camp gate. But there hasn't been anybody there since the town decided to come down hard on the U-Calls.
So this pass is useless?
Not necessarily. You need to add a stamp that looks like the official Valsimbor seal. The police aren't that sharp-sighted around here, I have to admit. Anyway, I didn't say a word. Good luck, miss. And don't forget to drop by my tavern when you're in Valsimbor.
Hello.
You look muck, Miss Gatewalk. Need something from Forge?
Well, yes, I do. I need a stamp that has the same shape as the Valsimbor seal and that I can use with the press at the camp gate.
Complicated. Need model. Tuk tuk. You have that, Miss Gatewalk? Give me lots of junk, or Smith cannot work with Forge. Complicated, complicated. Smith also need wax for mold. Give me lots of junk, or Smith cannot work with Forge.
Good junk. Stamp ready in not long time.
Only the stamp is missing. How practical.
Thank you. Miss Walker. Very happy to finally catch up with you.
Mr. Canton, what on earth do you want?
To take you back home, whether you like it or not. Come on, give me your hands, please.
Mr. Canton, I don't know how much the people who hired you promised for delivering me to them. But if it's only a question of money, maybe...
Stop right there, Miss Walker. You're being a tad insulting. Listen, my professional integrity has never been in doubt in over 20 years of work. Come on, wrists out. Mr. Marson? Finally, I have her. Yes, she is safe and sound. I have Miss Walker under control. I'll keep you informed of our progress. It'll take a day or two at most. I suppose there are a few procedural obstacles to overcome before we can leave the country.
Listen, all these things I'm accused of are completely untrue. Hans's murder, embezzlement, it's nonsense. And while we're wasting time here, I can't help the Yukels. And believe me, they really need it.
I am not your enemy, Miss Walker. If you haven't done anything, like you say, it's in your interest to go back and defend yourself in court. There's nothing left for you to do here anyway. Not everyone here is your friend in these parts, I'm afraid.
This Canton isn't the brightest bulb. If I can get him to believe I'm cooperating, I'll be able to sidetrack him and escape.
Well, Miss Walker?
If I scream loud enough, maybe the Yukels will hear me and come and help. It's sure worth a try.
Come on, do like I said, please.
Well, all right, Mr. Canton. You win.
I'm glad you're finally being reasonable, Miss Walker. Now we just need to wait for the representative of the regional military authorities for the administrative procedures. I don't think it'll take long to get our papers, so we can leave this place then.
How long do we have to wait? I've been through a lot over the last few months, you know. I'm recuperating. I'm still a bit weak.
Well, it could take a few hours at the outside.
Would you mind bringing me a glass of water? I don't feel too well. I feel a bit dizzy.
I'd have to leave you here in the meantime. I'm not sure that...
Please, Mr. Canton. I really think I'm going to faint.
Don't worry, Miss Walker. I'll see what I can do. But don't move.
Quick! I have to get free and get out of here while Canton is busy. That's no use to me. Useless. It didn't break. God, I need to find something else. Useless. It didn't break. God, I need to find something else. Get out of here before Canton comes back.
Miss Walker! No, wait! I have an arrest warrant for this woman. Arrest her! My pass! Give it back to me! Immediately, you hear?
My squid is absolutely fresh, miss. Listen, miss, it's fresh.
Things are heating up for Mayor Bulyakin.
That big boat, the Crystal, it's been rotting at the dock for years.
Since the town hall closed the port, we sometimes get the impression we're living in a ghost town.
We're going to see the Nomad Souk. Apparently they have good prices.
Hi there. Anything biting?
As if. 20 years there's been fewer fish, but sometimes you can get lucky. Go figure. It's really odd.
You seem to know the region well. Maybe you can fill me in a bit. I'd like to know a little bit more about the local legend. I was told that there's a monster down there, living at the bottom of the lake.
It's not a legend.
And how can you be so sure?
Back when, the lake froze over earlier in the season. People would go out and make holes in the ice in the middle of the lake, then fish like that. Sometimes they would even set up these cabins for the winter next to the hole. The old folk always said you should only cut a small hole, just wide enough so the fish could be pulled through when you landed them. No more than that. One day, this guy who was kind of odd cut a really big hole. To make it easier, he said. In case he caught a really big one. You don't have to believe me, but he's the one who went into the hole. Backwards. Into the depths. In less time than it takes to say it, the monster's arm came through the hole, then dragged the poor guy down to the bottom of the lake. That's why the old folks say never make a big hole in the ice, because of the monster that lurks below.
And how do you know all that?
Because the poor guy was my older brother. And I was fishing just next to him that day. So you think what you want. You have a good day, miss.
Are you okay, sir? One more step and you were in the drink.
I-N-O.
Pardon?
It's me, Captain Obo. Obo! Proud commander of the just as proud crystal. So don't you, sir, me.
Well, delighted. Captain, I'm Kate Walker. I'm looking for Steiners, the clockmaker.
If I fall in the water, Taylor, it'll be to go straight to hell. So don't fall in the water, Sailor, you understand? Bastard's waiting for me.
Who are you talking about?
The monster of the lake is waiting for us all, miss. Everyone's time comes eventually. To finish the work. Come on, back in the fight. Because you can never lower your guard. Never.
Tavern.
Someone stole 3 chickens last night.
I'd rather be left here on my own if you don't
mind. I bet it was those damn...
Yeah, we can't always accuse the foxes. You should go see about complaining to
the
mayor with all the others.
Miss.
I can't understand why those damn savages are stuck
all
here.
All those youngsters
it's
trying
not
to
like
act
anybody's
smart
making them
the
stay
Steiner
the damn pipsqueak.
Really gets to me.
There's some making them stay connected to their religion. They believe in a whole pile of nonsense.
The lake is haunted by a demon.
Oh, yeah? I heard that someone up top decided to order them to stay here.
Waiting!
From central administration.
Excuse me, please, miss.
Yes?
I'm looking for Simon Steiners.
Simon Steiner is my grandfather. My name is Sarah. Sarah Steiner.
Pleased to meet you, Sarah. I'm Kate Walker. Can you tell me where I can find your grandfather's workshop?
Of course. You'll find his shop is at the end of the alleyway, on the left, just as you leave it, in the main avenue. Can I ask what you want with him? Because he's rather old, you know.
I'm accompanying the Yukul caravan. Apparently your grandfather is supposed to be making a mechanical prosthesis for Kirk, their spiritual chief, who had a bad accident recently. Without the artificial leg, Kirk won't be able to go along with the great migration of his people. And on top of that, the Yukuls won't leave without their guide.
You're accompanying the Yukuls? My God, you're so terribly lucky. When I was little, Grandfather used to tell me all about their adventures, full of mystery and magic.
Do you like life in Valsimbor?
Oh, there's really not that much to talk about here, you know. I spend all my time here or with Grandfather since he got sick.
There was no one who could keep an eye on him for you?
We can't afford it, I'm afraid. I also think I prefer it this way. My grandfather is my only family.
I guess you're pretty close to your grandfather?
Yes. Of course he can get a bit grumpy, especially the last few years. But he's actually really adorable, and you should see the work he does. Give him a few cogs and springs, and he'll give you some unbelievably incredible invention. He almost makes mechanical objects seem alive.
I see exactly what you mean. I used to know someone like that, too.
The only problem we have is that business collapsed when he got sick. I really do believe that if I didn't have the waitressing jobs to make ends meet, we'd probably have to close up shop.
You seem to like the Yukle, Sarah. I get the impression that's rare in Valsimbor.
It's true that when it comes to the Yukles, people around here can be a bit silly. They go out of their way to make the nomad scapegoats for all of the town's problems since they got stuck here.
But you don't, do you?
Of course not. Grandfather told me that he has actually seen 3 or 4 of the great ostrich migrations in his lifetime, and he always really respected those strange people. He even made sure I would admire them too, you know.
Thank you for your help.
I'll be stopping in to see Grandfather on my next break. Maybe I'll see you there.
Yes, I hope so. Goodbye, Sarah. That's the nice man who helped me leave the Yukle camp. I should go thank him.
I'd really suggest you steer well clear of Captain Obo, miss. He's always basically drunk as a skunk.
Lost your way, pretty girl?
Steiner! Hello. Are you Mr. Steiner?
Hmm?
I'm sorry to bother you, Mr. Steiner. My name is Kate Walker, and I've come to pick up the prosthesis for Kirk, the Yukle spiritual guide.
And well, dear Miss Walker. Dr. Efimova has informed me that the young man was not yet in any sort of condition to withstand the operation, and that...
Mr. Steiner, are you all right?
It is impossible. That pendant you have around your neck. I would be very obliged if you would entrust me with it for a moment. Please, Miss Walker.
Mein Gott! An XZ-2000 automaton heart in perfect working condition. A compensating spring memory. Pendulum ventricles and small mechanical pumps. Everything seems in excellent condition. Donnerwetter! Where on earth did you steal this, Miss Walker?
I did not steal it. It's a souvenir. It's all I have left of Oscar. A very dear friend.
Ah, so. And yet I am actually very familiar with this type of precision mechanism. An infernal precision. Incredible, unique expertise. For this was a Vorarlberg automaton, Miss Walker.
Yes. It was Hans Vorarlberg who designed this object, tell me, did you know him?
Oh, yeah. He even lived here a few years. We did a lot of work together. He taught me so many different things, you know. So it is useless to try and make up silly stories, Miss Walker. And I am afraid that I am not about to allow you to leave here as long as you have not told me the truth about where this object comes from. Are you afraid to answer?
Mr. Steiner, Oscar was a very special automaton. He inspired almost human emotions. But today he doesn't exist. He isn't dead, of course. Because what has never lived cannot die. Oscar was just dismantled. It had to be like that. All that I have left of him is that heart, a heart made of metal.
It's far more than just a heart, miss. It's far more like a kind of mechanical hard drive. A computer that is full of cogs, gears, and springs, but...
Mr. Steiner, are you all right?
My heart... need... my medication! Quickly!
Just don't move. I'll go and get your medication right away.